And with that, dearly beloved, in the Gospel of Matthew, Jesus tells us that where two or more of us are gathered in his name, there am I in the midst of them. And today, many more than two of us have come together, and we are invited with God to be present here as we bear witness to the marriage of Max and Sarah, and to surround them with our prayers and wishes for their joy. Sarah and Max, you have been called to marriage with each other, and God has blessed you through this calling. To all of you who are gathered to here today, we are here to form a circle of love and joy and prayer. In this wild and this wonderful corner of creation, we are invited to be, to breathe, and to become. Sarah and Matt have invited each of us to bear a special place here in this moment in their lives. They have chosen us to help create their beloved community. We bear witness to their covenant, which is made in the sight and the grace of God. I invite you now to pray together with me, first silently and then saying together our Father. Creator, Christ, and Comforter, be with us. Bless this day, bless this couple, bless this gathering. Be with us every step of the way, wherever our paths may take us. Remind us to call upon you as you taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. I would invite Maureen and Taylor to come forward at this time to share readings that have been selected by Sarah and Matt.
A reading from Ecclesiastes, The Value of a Friend. Two are better than one, because they have a good reward for their toil. For if they fall, one will lift up the other. But woe to one who is alone and falls and does not have another to help. Again, if two lie together, they keep warm. But how can one perform alone? And though one might prevail against another, two will withstand one. A threefold cord is not quickly broken. An excerpt from the Divine Comedy. Love, unutterable and perfect, flows into a pure soul, the way light rushes into a transparent object. The more love you receive, the more love you shine forth, so that, as you grow clear and open, the more complete the joy of loving is, and the more souls who resonate together, the greater the intensity of their love. For, mirror like, each soul reflects the other.
Now will you have Sarah to be your wife, and will you love her, cherish her, honor and keep her, in sickness and in health, in hardship and in ease, as long as you both shall live? If you consent, please say, I do.
I do.
Sarah, will you have Matt to be your husband, and will you love him, cherish him, honor and keep him, in sickness and in health, in hardship and in ease, as long as you both shall live? If you consent, please say, I do. So Matt and Sarah have selected many, many words today for us from different kinds of literature and song that bespeak their love for each other. But sometimes people never take the time to really put into their own words how they feel about each other. So I want to share just a few of the things that they shared with me about their love for each other. If I have your permission. Sarah loves that she can be herself with Matt. Since their first date, she's been able to trust him with her vulnerabilities. Whether it's being gluten-free, so that Matt chose not to chug beer at the Red Sox game, or being honest with him about bigger life-changing issues along the way. Matt appreciates about Sarah that she is easygoing and open with him, and he can be himself with her. He's never had to put up pretenses with her, not even at the Red Sox game. A night when he can't tell you who was playing or who won, because their first intense hours were all about the experience of being with and getting to know each other. Sarah says that their relationship has grown naturally and everything simply fell into place. Matt agrees that it wasn't about what was supposed to happen next. That had no bearing on their relationship. From that first date, through the extended time that they have been a couple, their connection has evolved easily. Their relationship has been healthy and integral. It's been a part of their busy, demanding, exciting, and challenging lives. But it isn't built only on big milestones, but upon the growing and living of everyday activities and experiences together. They can say this even though they spent the first 4 years with only 3 months, that they were not working and going to graduate school at the same time. And while they have indeed had their share of adventures and travels, they also remind us that they spent plenty of weekends working on Matt's case studies for his MBA or lesson plans for Sarah's seventh grade class. They find fulfillment from doing their own thing in each other's company. Sarah says that in her relationship, she feels safe and supported. And when she gets anxious, the same things are less scary when Matt is present to go through them with her. Their connection encourages Sarah to do things she wouldn't otherwise do. For example, training for and running a marathon, skiing and hiking. Matt loves that Sarah is open to trying new things, even if it was negative 30 outside in the cold while she was running to ski with her. She'll put herself out there and try something, do something, learn something, and experience something that she may not ever have anticipated wanting to do before. Sarah observes that Matt is committed to doing things all the way, and that's the focus and passion that he brings to their relationship. One of the stories, or a couple of the stories that they told about their love for each other, have to do with hiking. They're going hiking towards Ben Nevis, which is the highest point in Scotland. And Sarah, being the teacher that she is, did her homework. And she read the reviews and the trail guides. And she found out there was a pretty dangerous place for some people. And so sometimes risk-taking is not to go to the place that is the most dangerous place you can go. It is to be honest and vulnerable with the one that you are trusting. And so on that hike, she told Matt that she wasn't comfortable and she wasn't ready to go to the top of Ben Nevis. And for Matt, the risk-taking is to let go of what he thinks the goal might be, because his priority is the time and experience with Sarah and winding up wherever they may be, successfully and safely together. Another time they hiked the Sugarbush Trail in Vermont. And although Matt usually knows the terrain pretty well, sometimes when you know things really well, you miss the right path and end up somewhere else. Off the trail, in the hail, in the middle of the woods, and rain. In Matt's words, he had no sense of where the end was, and although the unknown might be scary for
Sarah. And so what he appreciated was that Sarah's willing to follow him into the wilderness, but also that she's only willing to follow him into the wilderness up to a point. Came back to a path that they could both navigate together. Matt won't quit. He commits to whatever he's doing for the long haul, and he sees their relationship as a priority. Sarah loves that he is patient when she's anxious or a perfectionist, and that Matt gets her out of that place of being. Yet he does not undermine or invalidate her feelings. Rather, he's present to her, and he takes time to help her work through things in the way that she needs to, and he reflects Beth's observations, and he reminds her what she already knows. He helps her to trust her own wisdom and intuition, and yet she also trusts his observations and reflections. From what they've told us about each other, they offer each other steadiness and equilibrium, emotional and psychological intimacy. They offer each other big dreams and the detailed plans for how to get there together. They give each other humor and patience. They have bigger horizons and close-up moments together. They take turns being the teachers and the learners. Sarah taught him how to swim, or improved his swimming. And with that comes a lot of breathing, pacing, finding your balance, and keeping your rhythm. Together, they approach life as a both and rather than either or. They know and love each other with open eyes and open hearts. They know each other from the inside out. They're willing to take chances and have new adventures. But so much of the way that they love each other, as they have told us, is built on the small and simple daily milestones of living together and sharing the commonplace and the ordinary as well as the extraordinary in the life that they are building together. These are the words that they share with us about their love for each other. Did you exchange vows? Sarah, I take you to be my wife.
Sarah, I take you to be my wife.
I offer you my love.
I offer you my love.
I offer you my strength.
I offer you my strength.
I offer you my support.
I offer you my support.
I offer you my loyalty.
I offer you my loyalty.
I offer you my faith.
I offer you my faith.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
I'm sorry, I'm going to put it up for you. Matt, I take you to be my husband.
Matt, I take you to be my husband.
I offer you my love.
I offer you my love.
I offer you my strength.
I offer you my strength.
I offer you my support.
I offer you my support.
I offer you my loyalty.
I offer you my loyalty.
I offer you my faith.
I offer you my faith.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
As long as we hold each other.
As long as we hold each other.
And now we're going to enjoy another reading shared with us by Mary and Dennis, if they would come forward.
To live at excitement for even 5 years. What would become of your work, your appetite, your sleep, your friendship? But of course, ceasing to be in love need not mean ceasing to love.
Love, in the second sense, love is distinct from being in love, is not merely a feeling. It is the deep unity maintained by the will and deliberately strengthened by habit, and reinforced by your grace with both these partners asked and received from God.
They can have this love for each other, even at those moments when they do not like each other, as you love yourself, even when you do not like yourself.
Being in love first moved them to promise fidelity. Their quieter love enables them to keep the promise.
It is on this love that the engine of marriage is run. Being in love was the explosion that started.
Begin the exchange of rings with Matt and Sarah. Rings are given in token and pledge of your constant faith in each other and your abiding love for each other. Rings are an outward and visible sign of your inward and your spiritual bond, the bond that unites you in love. Friends, we are all invited together to bless these rings because we are the beloved community that has come here today to share this covenant with Sarah and Matt. So please, if you would hold your hands up, cup your palm, and offer your own blessing as I say these words over the rings. Gracious God, bless these symbols of covenant promise, that they may remind Sarah and Matt of your encircling love and unending faithfulness, that in their life together they may know joy and peace in one another. Amen. Sarah, I give this ring as a symbol of my vow.
Sarah, I give this ring as a symbol of my vow.
And with all that I am.
With all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I commit myself to you.
I commit myself to you.
This is where you're all invited to bless this union together. Matt and Sarah, gathered with you are your families and friends, loving community that you invited here today. There are people and relationships and loves that connect with you today. But these connections are already woven deeply into your stories with love and family. In times to come, you will also have others that will also become part of your narrative. But today, here, gathered in this place, is the community that is present to be with you as you shape this covenant. Their presence here is a sacred gift, so I invite you to turn towards them and receive them the blessing that they will give to you. And now I ask you, as members of the beloved community that upholds Matt and Sarah, will you pledge your support to this covenant that they are making today? If you do, please say very robustly, "We will." In our presence and before God, we affirm that a covenant has been made. Before us, Sarah and Matt have committed their gifts, their love, and their lives to be shared together. A new family has been created. I would invite now Pat and Tim to come forward for a reading and a prayer.
This is a reading from St. Paul to the Colossians. As God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, clothe yourselves with kindness, compassion, weakness, humility, meekness, and patience. Bear with one another, and if anyone has a complaint against another, forgive each other. Just as the Lord has forgiven you, so you must also forgive. Above all, clothe yourselves with love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. This is the word of the Lord.
Let us respond to our prayers this afternoon with, Lord, hear our prayer. May the lives of Matt and Sarah, and all here present, be clothed with love, kindness, compassion, humility, and patience. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May the love of God be reflected in the lives of Sarah and Matt, and that all here present may seek to live out the lives of faith, hope, and charity. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And thanksgiving for the love, prayers, and support of the families and friends of Matt and Sarah gathered here this weekend. And in thanksgiving for all those who have touched them and whom they have touched, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, who join us in spirit today, may they rest in the peace of a merciful God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we all may have confidence in the words of the prophet Jeremiah for Matt and Sarah. Those words, for surely I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. Plans for your welfare and not for evil, to give you a future and a hope. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all of us, and especially for Sarah and Matt, that when we ask what the Lord requires of us, we all will answer to do justice and to love kindness and to walk humbly with our God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For these and for all of our prayers, we pray to the Lord from Matt and Sarah.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Vows for marriage before God in this gathering, I announce with joy